We are excited to have PK joining us now from The Rock Prudential Center just down the road. We're here in Secaucus, New Jersey. You're down there in Newark. So welcome to the area, first and foremost. And also, how would you describe the reception that you just received from the Jersey faithful?
Yeah, the last couple days have been really overwhelming. They've taken me in with open arms, and I just think that everybody's going to see all the flash and dash in the arena today and with the press conference. But what's really moved me is just kind of what they've done behind closed doors for me and my family and my friends and Lindsay that have come with me to New Jersey this week just to kind of find a place and get acquainted with everyone in the front office and the management. And they've been beyond first class. I mean, everything this week, the ownership group, Josh Harris and everybody else has just opened their arms with, you know, love. And I can definitely feel the love here. So it's really exciting for me.
PK, you've been traded before. You've been part of high profile trades before. Even if you think it might be coming, it still could be a little unsettling. When you first heard of the news of being traded to New Jersey Devils, what were your thoughts?
Well, I was still sleeping when I got the phone call. And
I've been there.
I got a phone call. Yeah, I got a phone call from Brandon Walker, who handles team relations there in Nashville. And he just said that David wants to talk to you. So I gave David a call, and then he told me that he had traded me. And you know, the first 5 minutes of the call was just him talking about my time there and just how appreciative they were. And that was probably the toughest thing to hear is that, you know, it's one thing leaving a place where you may, you know, if you don't feel that you're welcome or not. But there was never a moment like that in Nashville when I was there. It was really a great time, great teammates, great organization, first class all the way. And from David to the ownership to the coaching staff, Lavi, everyone, they treated me so well there. And but you know, it's a cap league now, man, so you know, things got to happen, things got to change, especially when you don't win. And we didn't hit our goal of winning the Stanley Cup, so you know, the reality is I'm in a better place for me right now and a team that needs me and wants me, and that's definitely how I feel, you know, being here. So I'm really excited. When I found out about the news, I was over the moon. I almost jumped on the top of my counter. I was so excited that it was Jersey with the opportunity. So,
well, in terms of hockey, it also had to be a little difficult because you went from a veteran proven team like the Predators to a team with a lot of questions still, a ton of potential in New Jersey, but a lot of young players that are still waiting to come into their own. So how do you see your role on this team with the Devils, and what excites you about that opportunity?
Oh, I'm really excited. It's an opportunity. And, you know, listen, I feel like I've played on middle of the pack teams that are supposed to win the Stanley Cup. And now I'm playing for a team that's very, very young with a lot of high end talent, and anything can happen. You know, I think it's really going to come down to the guys in the locker room and how we help the young guys develop and how quickly we can help them develop. And, you know, I've heard great things about Coach Hines, and obviously Ray Shiro, his body of work speaks for itself and what he's done in the league and his reputation. So I think that the New Jersey Devils are well on their way of being a contender, and I don't think they're done either. I think they're going to look for ways to make our team better if they can, and that's what excites me about being here. My job is just to come in and help in all areas and all situations, and I think I said a lot of those things in the press conference today.
PK, we know you're a larger-than-life personality, and that's a good thing. Hockey needs more of that. The world needs more of that. But sometimes I have to clarify, because you have a lot of fun and you share a lot of your training on social media, don't question your preparation. So how is your preparation going? How healthy are you feeling heading into the fall and into training camp?
Yeah, well, I encourage people, if you're not following me already and you don't know about my preparation, follow me and you'll find out. No, it's been great. I've been really enjoyed the summer. I haven't really taken much time off. You know, when I miss parts of the season, it's just an opportunity to start training right away as the season's over. So I kind of took maybe a week and a half off, and then started training again. So I've been training for a while now. I feel great. Been on the ice for a couple weeks, and yeah, I'm just excited. I'm excited to get to training camp. But there's still a lot of time left in the summer. Right. So, you know, this is great. I'm excited this week. But, you know, tomorrow I got
to
go back. And, tomorrow I got a show here in New York. Yeah, I got to go to New York and then back in the gym again and just enjoy. And then next week I'll be in Toronto enjoying some time with family and friends. I have my hockey school that I do in Toronto every year and my hockey school in Montreal. We have PKSF week in Montreal, which will be a fun week where we're going to raise a lot of money for the hospital and for some more children and family. So I got a lot to look forward to this summer, but aside from that, it's just business as usual. My days start early in the morning, You know, 5:30, 6 a.m., and try to get everything in.
Yeah, the workouts are well documented. It is a great thing to follow you on Instagram, but is there anything that you've had to do to change the way you prepare for a season physically as you've gotten older and older? Because I'm sure it is different trying to keep up with the league as it gets younger.
Well, listen, I mean, there's the list goes on of some of the best athletes in the world who had to change things in their training and their preparation. I mean, I remember LeBron James saying that he had to lose weight after he won a championship. And, you know, Tiger Woods had to change his swing coach when he was the number one golfer in the world. So, You know, a lot of athletes have had to do different things throughout their career. I don't look at it that way. I'm just looking at areas where I can get better. So, you know, if people notice a change, I don't really see it as a change, a bad thing or a negative thing. It's just, what do I have to do to get better? So, I've been working with my team and whether it's on the ice, off the ice, just to get better and get better prepared to dominate this season.
All right, PK, that was a fun press conference you just went through. Fans were hooting and hollering the drum line, but really, The robe stole the show. What did you think of the Ric Flair replica robe you were presented with?
Unreal. Unreal. All I need is my diamond ring, my limousine, my jet in the back or whatever. I didn't have any of those things, but it was pretty amazing. You know, they did their research, and apparently, That's what made it so special is coming in here. Yeah, man, the amount of gifts that I received, and not just the actual material gifts, but, you know, just the pictures of my childhood as a kid and my family. And, you know, they made me a jacket with my mom and dad's, you know, flag and where they're from in the Caribbean. And, you know, that means a lot to me. So they've made it very personal, and it's a family here. And, you know, I can only hope that most professional athletes throughout their career, you know, we're very lucky to do what we do, and we make a lot of money doing what we do, but very rarely sometimes can you feel like it's a family. And I've been very lucky in my career to play for some great organizations, but I'll tell you, you know, they definitely make you feel like family here. So, you know, listen, any players who want to play in New Jersey, it's a great place to play, I'm sure.
That's a great message. But real quick, where is the robe going to be? Is it going to make an appearance in the regular season? Are we going to see this again?
I don't know. That's the whole, you know what? Listen, you guys know this as well as I do. You're always waiting to see what the next thing is. So we'll just have to find out. I mean, I might leave that robe in Taylor Hall's stall just to see what he thinks of it when he comes in for training camp.
Perfect.
Good spot for it.
Yes. Thanks so much, PK. Enjoy what's a very busy summer, it sounds like, for you. We'll see you back on the ice very shortly.
All right. Thanks, guys.